This is Dr. Carlo Oger, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about urinary tract infections. If you're watching this video and you were diagnosed with a urinary tract infection having any of the following, please stop the video and go to your nearest emergency department right away. If you have fever over 100 degrees, if you have no improvement by the third day of treatment, if you have increasing back or abdominal pain, if you have repeated vomiting or you are unable to keep your medicines down, if you have weakness, dizziness, or fainting, if you're a female and have vaginal discharge, pain, redness, or swelling of the labia, then you should come back to the emergency department. This picture shows the normal anatomy of the urinary tract. Urine is made in the kidneys, collected in the renal pelvis, and travels through the ureter to the urinary bladder. Once stored and accumulated, can be excreted through the urethra. This picture shows some of the many causes of urinary tract infections. Some of them you can see in this picture, like extension of the infection from elsewhere, invasion from surrounding organs, stones, cancer, incomplete bladder emptying, and ascending infection through the urethra. A simple urine dipstick is sufficient in most cases to make the diagnosis by showing leukocyte esterates and/or nitrates. But if the urine is very dilute, it can be falsely negative. Also, if you have the classic symptoms of a UTI, no testing is necessary to diagnose you with a UTI. But at times, if you have the classic symptoms and the urine dipstick is negative, we'll still treat you probably as a urinary tract infection. But follow-up will be very important to make sure other potential causes of the symptoms are ruled out, like urethritis and others. UTI can progress up the urinary tract into the kidneys. This is called pyelonephritis. By then you will have flank pain, nausea, vomiting, increasing pain, body aches, etc. Pyelonephritis can be a medical emergency since once the kidneys get infected, it can cause kidney damage. A bladder infection or cystitis usually causes a constant urge to urinate and burning when passing the urine. Urine may be cloudy, smelly, or dark. There may be pain in the lower abdomen. A bladder infection occurs when bacteria from the vaginal area enter the bladder opening or urethra. This can occur after sexual intercourse, wearing tight clothing, dehydration, and many other factors. Here you can see both the routes for kidney infection and factors that predispose you to have pyelonephritis. You may also be given pyridium to reduce the burning sensation. This medicine will cause your urine to become a bright orange color. The orange urine may stain your clothing. You may wear a pad or panty liner to protect your clothing. Avoid sexual intercourse until your symptoms are gone completely. Avoid caffeine, alcohol, and spicy foods. They can irritate the bladder. Make sure you take your antibiotics completely, even if you're feeling better. Drink plenty of fluids, but avoid alcohol. Cranberry juice changes the acidity of the urine and helps halt bacterial growth. Return to this facility or see your doctor if all symptoms are not gone after 3 days of treatment. It is possible that the bacteria causing your infection are too smart or resistant to your prescribed antibiotic. Therefore, your physician might need to change the antibiotic or the dose. Men should have the prostate checked and get treated if they have an enlarged prostate, as this can cause recurrent urinary tract infections. Do not take herbal preparations that you may find at health food stores. Some may actually cause kidney disease. Admission to the hospital. For most urinary tract infections, even early kidney infections, no admission will be necessary, But if you have signs of kidney infection and significant symptoms like dehydration, vomiting, high white count, high fever, or you look ill, you will probably be admitted to the hospital. For more videos like this one, please visit edexitvideo.com.